हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दून इंटरनेशनल स्कूल गुरदासपुर बॉट ए ऑनलाइन समर कैंप फॉर यू। वी बॉट अ नंबर ऑफ इंडोर एक्टिविटीज फॉर यू इन दिस कैंप। सो इन मैथमेटिक्स वी बॉट अ बंच ऑफ ट्रिक्स फॉर यू इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वैदिक मैथमेटिक्स। सो कम ऑन, लेट्स एंजॉय अवर समर कैंप विद वैदिक मैथमेटिक्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू शुड नो वॉट इज वैदिक मैथमेटिक्स। सो इट इज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ टेक्निक्स और सूत्र और वी कैन से स्किल्स टू सॉल्व मैथमेटिकल प्रॉब्लम्स इन ईजी एंड फास्टर वे। सो दिस मैथमेटिक हेल्प इन डिवेलपिंग स्पीड एंड एक्यूरेसी। सो हैव अ फन विद मैथ्स एंड एक्सपीरियंस कॉन्फिडेंस टू कैलकुलेट फास्टर दैन कैलकुलेटर। एवरीबडी वॉन्ट्स टू बिकम अ फास्टर दैन कैलकुलेटर। इज़न्ट यू वॉन्ट टू बिकम अ फास्टर दैन कैलकुलेटर? येस, देन कम ऑन, learn some tricks from Vedic mathematics. So Vedic mathematics help in developing interest and calculating capacity and mathematics. So it is a name given to ancient system of mathematics which was rediscovered from Vedas by the personality called Shri Bharati Krishna Tirth ji. According to his research, all the maths is based on 16 sutra or word formulas or we can say tricks by which we can solve all the sums in mathematics. So with Vedic mathematics we can solve difficult to difficult problem and huge sum with the very striking and beautiful methods we are going to learn. So this is a personality who discovered Vedic mathematics, Shri Bharati Krishna Tirth ji. So he was born on March 1884 and known for his book Vedic Mathematics. So what are the 16 sutra he found? Let us have a look on it. So these are 16 sutra from which we are going to use few and solve our sums in this camp. So why it is called Vedic? Vedic means Vedas, which means fountain head of all the knowledge. Supreme Court of India gave the meaning to Vedic as a time factor. Also the Vedic mathematics is secular, which means anyone from anywhere in the world can practice it and take advantage of its result. So Vedic maths has a number of advantages. So what are that advantages? It helps a person to solve 10 to 15 times faster. It will reduce your stress and burden and provide one line answer. It will increase your concentration. Your right and left side of brain will develop by increasing visualization and concentration. Your time is saved during your exams. It will improve your concentrations. Logical thinking processes get enhanced. So see how many advantages you have with Vedic mathematics. So we should learn these tricks. So first of all, we'll do the trick number one, squaring of a number ending with 5. So see, this is modern method and one is Vedic method. Modern method you solve during your calculations, very long method. Vedic method, see the Vedic method, we will provide you answer in one line in just 5 to 10 seconds. So what you have to do? What is the trick? So 65 into 65. See the first digit is 6. Now you will multiply 6 with a number 1 greater than it. That is 7. So 6 into 7 is 42. It is written 42 there. Next step is 5 into 5. That is 25. So 4, 2, 2, 5 is the answer. Now take one example, 15 square, 15 into 15. How will we do the squaring of this number? So first of all, see the first digit, that is 1 here. So first digit is 1. Now you will multiply 1 with one number greater, that is 2. This is comes to be 2. Now course next step is 5 into 5. Step number 1, step number 2, 5 into 5. which is 25. Now you will compile the answer from these two steps. So you will write answer of step number 1, answer of step number 2, like this. So answer is 225. Take one more example. 115 into 115. Here you have 3 digits. Now leave 5, see the digit 11. Now take out 11. You will multiply this 11 with the number 1 greater than 11 is 12. 11 into 12 is 132. See, then of course 5 into 5, which is 25. Now compile the result with these two answers. We will write 13225. So this is from first step, this is from second step. So answer is 13225, which is a square of 115. So see how it is easy to calculate square of any number ending with digit 5 using this trick. I hope you all understood it. The next is to do square of any other number not ending with 5 but ending with any other digit. So here is example of 98 square, whose answer is 9604. So we'll do square of 98. The first step is to choose the base. So see, we have the bases 10, 100, 1000, like this. So 98 is nearer to 100. So we choose a base that is 100. Now next step is to see how much 98 is less than 100. So 100 minus 98 is 2. Okay, so when it is lesser than 100, we call deficiency. So what is the next step? Third step. Step number 3, what is the deficiency? Minus it from the original number. 98 minus 2 is 96. Now, step number 4. What is the deficiency? 2. You will do the squaring of this 2. We get 4. But you will not write 4 like this. You will write 04. Why? Because the base 100 has 2 zeros. So 0 and 4. You have to make 2 digits. Now compile the answer from step number 3 and step number 4. The answer is 9604, which is the answer for square of 98. Now take another example of 104 square. 104 into 104. The first step is same. You will choose the base. So what will be the base here? We all know that is 100. Now next step, second step is you will see 104 is greater than 100. So how much it is greater? 104 minus 100 is 4. There we got deficiency. Here we get surplus. We called it as surplus. Now third step. What is the third step? You will add this surplus to 104. When you get surplus, you will add. When you will get deficiency, you will minus. So it will be 108. Now last step, fourth step is, what is the surplus? 4. Surplus 4 square, that is 16. We know base 100 has 2 zeros. We got 2 digits. No need to put 0 now. So compile the answer from this. Answer is 10816. You will write answer on this side, left hand side, and this on your right hand side. And this is the answer of square of 104. I hope you understood how to calculate square of any number, either greater than 100 or smaller than 100, by these 4 steps in just 10 seconds. I hope You all will apply this trick in solving squaring of any number ending either with digit 5 or not with digit 5 following this few steps. Thank you.